These niggas talking out of their necks. Don't put no coughing out of your mouth. I'm way too paranoid for a threat. Hey, let's get it, bro. DOT, the money, power, respect.
The last one is better.
Say yes, a lot of goofies with a check. I mean, I hold them sentiments symbolic. My temperament bipolar, I choose violence. Okay, let's get it up. It's time for him to prove that he's a problem.
Niggas clicking up, but pay not be legit. No 40 water, tell him.
Yeah, get up with me. Fuck sneak this and first person shooter. I hope they came with three switches. I crash out like fuck rap. This Melly Mel if I had to. Got two T's with me. I'm snatching chains and burning tattoos. It's up. Lost too many soldiers not to play it safe. If he walk around with that stick, it ain't Andre 3K. Think I won't drop the location. I still got PTSD. Motherfuck the big three. Nigga, it's just big me. Nigga, boom.
Shots have definitely been fired by Kendrick Lamar in the area of lyricist. Kendrick Lamar undeniably has dissed Drake and J. Cole in the new song Like That, which is featured on Future and Metro Boomin's new album, We Don't Trust You.
I'm really like that, and your best work is a light pack, nigga. Prince outlived.
There's a lot of artists on this album, but Kendrick Lamar's disses towards J. Cole and Drake are definitely not going unnoticed. A lot of people have been fired up and really been in a frenzy about it. But these rappers have actually had some beef for over a decade. If you listen to all the subliminal hits that have been thrown out there, this has definitely been going on for a while. And while Kendrick Lamar and Drake have both thrown beef at each other, and even with J. Cole, they both seem to have some type of respect and express that they think that each other are both talented. But this area of dissing makes you wonder, what is J. Cole and Drake going to do next? Because in all honesty, I think that Kendrick Lamar is superior in that area of having to be able to create an energy that really transforms his narrative. And a lot of it has to do with who he is as an individual, his cosmic connection towards the universe, of course. So yes, this is an astrology reading. I've read Kendrick Lamar's birth chart many times, but I am excited to read it again. Kendrick Lamar is a rapper, he is a songwriter, and he is a producer. He was born June 17th, 1987 in Compton, California. His full name is Kendrick Lamar Duckworth, and he has gained a lot of recognition and has been critically acclaimed in his major label debut studio, The Good Kid, Mad City, released in 2012. Lamar's music often addresses a lot of social issues, and in all honesty, I think it's quite more poetic, and it shows a lot of energy of struggles and obstacles. His rap is known for storytelling abilities and also being very initiative and innovative. He is seen to be very much as a unique artist in comparisons to some of the other rappers. And don't get offended if you are like a huge J. Cole fan or Drake fan, but Kendrick Lamar to me is superior in his rap skills. And a lot of it has to do with his astrological chart, meaning his birth chart. So let's get into it. Kendrick Lamar is a sun in Gemini. That sun in Gemini energy really shows that energy of the messenger. He's very intelligent. He's able to be very quick and witted. And he's also area of charisma really shows in a lot of his situations. He's able to adapt to his areas of communication that people not only receive well, but they also hear it quite well. He also has a moon in Pisces. This energy of the moon in Pisces was going through a dissonating phase, which is known as the waning phase, where it seems like a disruption. It seems like an area of chaos created with that Gemini sun makes me feel that he does have a little bit of chaotic energy, and it shows in his areas of lyricism. A lot of people solve a lot of his lyrics almost as a Rubik's Cube, or like a pattern or a jigsaw. There's a lot of hidden messages in his storytelling, and people who understand that about him see why he is a more sexual rapper compared to Drake. Sorry, Drake. He was also born on the year of the rabbit, and he is known as a life path number 3. The rabbit is seen to have like a comforting nature to them. They're also seen as very peaceful, which you could also see with the Pisces moon. Especially with a Pisces moon, you feel like there is a direct emotional connection that leads into the area of consciousness. So he is very concerned about what he is saying in his rap, because he knows that a lot of people will see it as messages. Like, when you think about the music frequency and the artists that Kendrick Lamar supports and how he would see it to like the community in comparisons to Drake, like there's no way Kendrick Lamar is putting Sexy Red on. I'm sorry, but he's above that level. Intellectually, frequency wise, and just consciousness. He also has a birth date of 17, which makes me know that he is very courageous, and he also stands out a lot more than other people. He has a lot of leadership abilities. Kendrick Lamar also has his Mars and his Mercury in Cancer, and he has that Venus in Gemini. First, I want to talk about the Mars in Cancer. This alignment just feels like it could definitely do some damage. It could hurt some feelings, and it could do it intentionally and unintentionally. Another thing that I want to talk about is in this diss track, Kendrick Lamar compares himself to Prince. He basically says that his music's going to continue to grow like how Prince's did past Michael Jackson, because Prince lived longer than Michael Jackson. It was kind of a very interesting connection, considering that Prince is a Gemini as well. So I thought this was interesting. And we see that Kendrick Lamar also has a Venus and a Chiron in Gemini. When I think about Geminis, I do really think that Geminis are a lot of that solar energy of the communication of the messenger. So Geminis definitely do well in that energy of communication. He also has a Jupiter in Aries, which feels very spontaneous. It lets me know that he's able to create some space around who he is as an individual and continue to grow. One of the things that stands out to me about his birth chart is he has a Saturn and he has a Uranus, both in Sagittarius. This energy of these two dynamics of planets feels rebellious. It also feels bold. And it feels like when people try to put constrictions on him, he really tests the boundaries. He also tests that energy of continuing to see higher philosophies that maybe other people in his field don't necessarily see. He also has that area where he wants to grow past being like a rapper, just a rapper. Like, to him, I think he's probably going to do more than just rapping. I could see him definitely even like doing some type of philosophy work and really kind of pushing that where it feels very rebellious and revolutionary. Also has a Neptune in Capricorn, which shows this energy of putting that place of dreams into his everyday work, his everyday legend status. He has a Pluto in 7 degrees, which is seen as that area of the mystic, of secrets. And when we think of that Pluto energy in Scorpio, it makes you feel like there is like this mystery about him, and a lot of people are kind of want to learn more. They're going to want to learn more about him, more about him on like a personal space, but I feel like he keeps that energy quite quiet. He does for personal reasons. But when I think about like legendary Gemini rappers, I automatically think of Tupac, and Kendrick Lamar kind of gives me the same Tupac type vibe, very poetic. He just has that legendary status.
Take off from fabricated dreams and the microwave memes. It's a real world outside. Take off your idols.